In early January last year, then Prime Minister Dr. Mahathir Mohamad asked Mazli Malik to resign as the Education Minister. While Mazli may essentially be the first minister sacked by Mahathir in the Pakatan Harapan administration, Mazli wasn't the first Mahathir had wanted to sack. This was revealed by former Deputy Defence Minister Liu Ching Thong in his new book on Lim Kit Siang, which also gave a glimpse on what happened behind the scenes in the Pakatan Harapan government. According to Liu, he found out from more senior Pakatan Harapan leaders that Mahathir had wanted to remove then Energy, Science, Technology, Environment and Climate Change Minister Yeo Bee Yin over her defiance on Lynas and other environmental issues. Liu wrote that the Harapan leaders managed to dissuade Mahathir from executing his plan to sack Yeo. On August 15, 2019, the Atomic Energy Licensing Board, an agency under Yeo at the time, announced new and significant conditions for Lynas operating license. Among others, the conditions required Lynas to shift its cracking and leaching facility back to Australia within 4 years. It was the same process that led to a build-up of radioactive waste at the Lynas Rare Earth Processing Plant in Gebeng, Kuantan. The AELB also instructed Lynas to terminate its ambitions to commercialise the waste, which the firm argued is low in radiation. Lynas also had to build a permanent deposit facility to store the waste that had already been produced since 2012 and will continue to produce until 2023, when the cracking and leaching process is finally moved to Australia. Yeo's office has yet to respond to a request for comment. In the book, Liu did not elaborate on the specifics of what had upset Mahathir.